Ever wondered how sunlight turns into electricity? How do photovoltaic cells, the heart of solar panels, work? Well, let's dive right in. A solar module or solar panel is made up of six main components. And the star of this solar show is the photovoltaic cell. This tiny titan is responsible for generating electricity. The term photovoltaic might sound a bit fancy, but it's quite straightforward when you break it down. Photo refers to light and voltaic to electricity. So photovoltaic effectively means light electricity. And that's exactly what these cells do. They convert light into electricity. This magical transformation of sunlight into electrical energy by a solar cell is referred to as the photovoltaic effect. Hence, we often call solar cells photovoltaic cells, or simply PV cells. Now, a single solar module is like a chorus line made up of many photovoltaic cells. Each cell does its part, absorbing sunlight and using that light energy to create an electrical current. And just like a chorus line, the real power comes when all the cells perform together. The current created by all of these cells adds up to enough electricity to help power your home. To give you a sense of scale, a typical panel used on a residential rooftop will have about 60 cells, all linked together. For commercial solar installations, we see larger panels with 72 or more photovoltaic cells. So, how do these cells produce electricity? It's a three-act play. Light is absorbed and knocks electrons loose. These loose electrons flow, creating an electrical current. And finally, the electrical current is captured and transferred to wires. Yes, it's a complex process, but it's also fascinating. Each PV cell is made of materials that can absorb photons from the sun and create a flow of electricity. And when these electrons get excited by photons, they produce a flow of electricity known as a direct current. So, in a nutshell, photovoltaic cells are the tiny yet mighty warriors converting sunlight into usable energy. But what's this photovoltaic effect we just mentioned? Let's delve deeper. You see, the photovoltaic effect is the process by which sunlight, or more specifically, photons, the tiny particles that make up sunlight, are converted into electricity in a solar cell. It's like a little bit of magic, but it's actually all about science. First things first, light absorption. The journey begins when sunlight strikes the photovoltaic cell. The cell is made of a semiconductor material, typically silicon, that's been treated to interact with photons. As these photons hit the cell, they excite the electrons in the silicon, causing them to break free and start moving, creating what we call an electrical current. Now, onto the second step, the creation of the electrical current. We have two layers of silicon in play here, each one treated in a specific way to create an electric field. One side has a net positive charge and the other a net negative charge. This electric field acts like a one-way street, directing the flow of the excited electrons in one direction, thus generating an electrical current. But where does this current go? That's where our third step comes in, capturing and combining the current. The electrical current created by the electrons is captured by metal plates on the sides of each solar cell. These plates collect the electrons, transfer them to wires, and voila! We have electricity flowing through the wiring to a solar inverter and then throughout your home. However, it's important to mention that a single photovoltaic cell isn't enough to power your entire home. We need to wire multiple solar cells together and install them on a substrate to create solar panels. When installed in groups, these panels form a solar power system capable of generating enough energy for a home. And that, folks, is the magic of the photovoltaic effect, turning sunlight into electricity. So how exactly does a PV cell absorb sunlight? Time to shed some light on this. The photovoltaic journey begins when sunlight, brimming with countless tiny particles known as photons, strikes a photovoltaic cell. Now, these solar cells are no ordinary pieces of equipment. They're crafted from a special semiconductor material, most commonly silicon, that's been treated to interact with photons. When sunlight reaches the surface of a silicon solar cell, a fascinating process begins. The incoming light energy, packed with photons, causes the electrons in the silicon to become excited and begin to loosen, initiating a flow that we commonly refer to as an electrical current. This, in essence, is the birth of the solar electricity that can power your home. But how does silicon, a seemingly ordinary element, manage to initiate this extraordinary process? Well, it's all about the treatment. Silicon used in photovoltaic technology is crafted into two layers, each one specially treated, or as we say in the trade, doped, to create an electric field. Imagine one side of the silicon having a net positive charge and the other a net negative. This electric field acts like a traffic cop at a busy intersection, directing the flow of the loosened electrons in one specific direction, which in turn generates an electrical current. Now, with the electrical current in motion, it's time for the next step. Metal plates on the sides of each solar cell are ready and waiting to collect these newly mobilized electrons and transfer them to wires. From here, the electrons continue their journey, flowing as electricity through the wiring to a solar inverter and then throughout your home. So the first step in our solar energy journey starts with a simple photon striking our solar cell. It's here, in this tiny interaction, that the potential for powering your entire home begins. It's a little bit of everyday magic, happening right there on your rooftop. Now that our electrons are loose and ready to go, what's next? Well, the magic is just beginning. The electrons are now in a state of movement or flow, which is the basis of an electrical current. But how does this happen, you may ask? The secret lies in the unique structure of the photovoltaic cell. Remember the two layers of silicon we talked about earlier? Each layer is treated differently, a process known as doping, to create an electric field within the cell. One side has a surplus of electrons, giving it a net negative charge, while the other side lacks electrons, giving it a net positive charge. This difference in charge creates an electric field. When our excited, loose electrons encounter this electric field, they are forced to move in one direction. That's right, just like a crowd moving through a one-way gate at a concert, the electrons can only go one way, from the negative layer to the positive layer. This movement or flow of electrons is what we refer to as an electrical current. Now here's where it gets a bit tricky. The electrical current generated by the solar cell is a form of direct current, or DC. This means that the electrons flow in one consistent direction, unlike alternating current, or AC, where the electrons switch directions periodically. Direct current is the raw, unprocessed form of electricity that our solar cell produces. But don't be fooled, this isn't the end of our journey. These electrons still have a long way to go before they can power your home. However, this stage is crucial as it sets the stage for the next part of the process, capturing and combining the electrical current. So in a nutshell, we've gone from sunlight to loose electrons, and now to an electrical current. It's a fascinating journey, isn't it? And it all happens within the tiny confines of a photovoltaic cell. And just like that, we have an electrical current, all thanks to our tiny photons. We have a current, but how do we use it? Let's find out. Now that we've got our electrons excited and flowing, we need to capture this energy and put it to work. This is where the design of the solar cell really comes into play. Each cell is equipped with metal plates on the sides. These plates have a crucial job. They collect the loose electrons that are buzzing around and transfer them to wires. Think of these metal plates as the gatekeepers of the cell. They're in charge of ushering the electrons out of the cell and into the wires. They're like the bouncers at a club, making sure that everyone who's inside is supposed to be there and guiding them where they need to go. Once the electrons are in the wires, they flow as electricity. This is the same type of electricity that powers your laptop, your fridge, your television, and all the other appliances in your home. It's a direct current, or DC, which is the type of electricity that batteries produce. But we're not just talking about one cell here. Remember, a standard solar panel for residential use contains 60 solar cells. Each one of these cells is generating its own current, and all of these currents need to be combined. This is done through the wiring of the panel. The currents from all the cells flow together, combining their power. It's like a team of horses pulling a carriage. One horse alone might struggle, but with a team working together, the carriage moves easily. Similarly, the combined current from all the cells in a solar panel is enough to produce usable electricity. This electricity is then sent to a solar inverter, which turns the DC electricity into an alternating current, or AC. This is the type of electricity that most home appliances use. The inverter is like the translator, taking the solar electricity and converting it into a language that your home can understand. So, there you have it. From sunlight to wires, our photons have come a long way. Through the magic of photovoltaic cells, we've harnessed the power of the sun and turned it into usable electricity. One photovoltaic cell by itself isn't much, but what happens when we combine hundreds of them? Well, when harnessed together, they become a powerhouse, quite literally. You see, each photovoltaic cell is like a single bee in a hive. On its own, it can produce a small amount of energy, but when combined with others, they can create a significant amount of electricity, enough to power an entire home. So, how does this work? Solar panels are essentially a collection of photovoltaic cells wired together and installed on a substrate, such as metal or glass. A typical residential solar panel, for example, might contain around 60 cells. These are then connected together to form a solar power system. Each cell in a panel works in harmony with its neighbors, absorbing sunlight and converting it into electricity. The electricity each cell produces is then combined, multiplying the overall power output. A panel with 60 combined cells might produce anywhere from 220 to over 400 watts of power. It's a classic case of the whole being greater than the sum of its parts. But the story doesn't end there. To power a home, you need more than one solar panel. Depending on factors such as temperature, hours of sunlight, and the household's electricity consumption, property owners may need a varying number of solar panels. This could mean several hundred or even several thousand photovoltaic cells, all working together to harness the sun's energy. In this way, what starts as a simple interaction between sunlight and a single semiconducting material becomes a mighty orchestra of cells, each playing their part in producing a flood of sustainable, renewable energy. And so, while a single photovoltaic cell may not seem like much, when we combine them, they become a testament to the power of teamwork and the remarkable potential of solar energy. Together, our photovoltaic cells are a force to be reckoned with, powering our homes with the energy of the sun. But why should we care about photovoltaic cells? Here's why. Photovoltaic cells, the heart of solar modules, are not just a marvel of modern science, but they also represent a significant step towards a sustainable future. By harnessing the boundless energy of the sun, we can generate electricity without the harmful emissions associated with burning fossil fuels. In fact, for every kilowatt hour of solar energy produced, we avoid approximately 1 pound of carbon dioxide, a major greenhouse gas. This means that a small rooftop solar system can offset the same amount of carbon emissions as planting over 100 trees every year. Energy independence is another compelling reason to care about photovoltaic cells. With solar power, we can decentralize our reliance on the grid, producing our own clean energy right at home. This freedom from utility companies not only reduces our vulnerability to power outages, but also gives us control over our energy costs. Once a solar power system is installed, the sunlight it uses is free, making the cost of electricity predictable and stable for decades. Moreover, photovoltaic cells are an economic boon. As the technology has matured, the cost of solar power has dropped dramatically. In many regions, it's now cheaper to generate electricity from solar panels than from traditional power plants. This cost-effectiveness, combined with various incentives and subsidies provided by governments around the world, makes solar power an increasingly attractive investment. Furthermore, photovoltaic cells play a crucial role in job creation. As the solar sector expands, so does the demand for skilled workers to manufacture, install, and maintain solar power systems. This growth in green jobs not only benefits the economy, but also helps transition the workforce towards a low-carbon future. Lastly, photovoltaic cells are the key to accessing electricity in remote or off-grid areas. Solar power systems can be installed virtually anywhere the sun shines, providing reliable electricity to people who otherwise might not have it. This ability to democratize energy access is one of the most transformative aspects of photovoltaic technology. In conclusion, the importance of photovoltaic cells extends far beyond their ability to convert sunlight into electricity. They represent a shift towards a more sustainable, independent, and equitable energy future. They are a testament to human ingenuity and our ability to innovate in the face of challenges. So next time you enjoy a sunny day, remember the mighty photovoltaic cells, silently turning that sunlight into the power that lights up our world.